What's up, K-Squad, and welcome back to another video. So today we are eating two hands Korean corn dogs. We have already started eating them. Started eating because, y'all, we were filming this same video for, we were probably sitting here, we had already filmed like 15 minutes worth of this video just for it to end up in slow motion. I did not know that the camera was in slow mode or whatever. So now we have to sit here, re-explain, go over again, and do everything once more. So, yeah. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on post notifications. Hit that bell so you know when we're dropping episodes. But until then, let's get into this episode. Y'all, we're so frustrated. That's a frustrated laugh. Because I'm so frustrated. Because we have to sit here, and we got so far along in the story on the other video that we have to sit here and do it again. So excuse any type of frustration or any redundancies in this video because we are very impatient people.
Oh, my phone.
And
20%.
We had already did everything that we're about to do over again. Okay. So yeah, let's get into this episode.
Tell the story all over again. Anyway, so this is a story time when we was moving back to Houston or whatever. So let me show y'all the pictures again.
Excuse any redundancies, anything, because we had already filmed this video. We are filming this again.
This is the truck, the U-Haul, the biggest one. I don't know if you guys can see it. You might have to insert it in the video.
Yeah, I'm already just inserted in the video, you guys, for you guys to see it. That's the truck. Just remember that truck because that is what we'll be talking about.
Okay. And this is the old apartment complex, too. I'm trying to
They're
try
not
to
really
going to
see
that.
It's just that all they see is the silhouette of the truck.
Anyway, the matter of the story is it was the biggest truck. So let me just give y'all the background story again. So it was back in July. I had went over to the place to price to see how much everything was going to be at the U-Haul place after I had got off from work. So I went up there, got the price. The lady wrote it all down and stuff, okay. So as I made it home, it's about maybe an hour later, someone called me to confirm and stuff, and I was like, okay, just go ahead and just confirm it and put the time and stuff. So.
And that was in July, the middle of July.
Yeah, the middle of July.
So mind you, we made the reservation like a month and a half before all this happened.
So, come all the way past to August 19th. It was like 6 something heading to the place to get the U-Haul truck. It was literally about 5 minutes away. And this guy, I think he was the general manager, his name was Kevin, I think, ended up calling and saying, you know, Mr., my last name, the truck that you're supposed to be getting, the person that had it did not return it. But we working on getting you another truck. I said, okay, cool, that's fine. But something told me to go to the place because I was literally right down the street. So I went where we went because it was me, him, his sister, and his sister girlfriend. Anyway, so we was like literally down the street anyway. So pulled up the headlight. A lot of trucks are the same size that we had supposed to get. And I asked the man, before I asked him, I got out of my own car. And of course, I was like, hell, they saying they ain't got the truck. Look at all these trucks right here. I can't just get one of these. Went inside, the guy, Kevin, he was like, those not out of town trucks, those in town trucks. Okay, cool. So they found me a truck, but the place opened up to 9 o'clock. Again, mind you, the reservation time for 7 as soon as they opened up. But again, they didn't have a truck. The person bring it back. So they had to find me a truck. And where the place the truck was at, they opened up at 9 o'clock. So that puts people way back. Way back. So we had ended up just going to Chicken Filet and going to my old job.
That was good.
And going to the bank, trying to knock some time down.
Because we had to kill 2 hours. And because our reservation was for 7 in the morning. So when we left there, we went to another U-Haul location there. And then that was a fail because, you know, they said they had no out-of-town trucks, and the one that they had was already reserved for someone who was moving to STL, which is St. Louis, Missouri, for those of you who don't know what STL means. And so that's when we went to Chick-fil-A to get breakfast and stuff like that.
So, back to the story. So, finally got the truck. Then, like I say, the truck... Well, you're going to see from the pictures, the truck looked good in the inside, outside, but it was like slow as hell, like so slow. So I had to go past the speed limit to stay up with any car.
Because I was in his car, he drove the truck, my sister drove my car, and then her girlfriend drove their car. So, yeah, just to clarify.
So, yeah, got the truck, went back to the old apartment complex, started loading the truck up and stuff like that.
That took about 2-3 hours, maybe.
Yeah. Then hit the road in traffic.
It was another 5 hours.
It took so long to get to the new apartment complex.
Probably about five and a half hours.
And then as we was driving, of course, everybody was tired and
it felt
frustrated.
So long.
It was a long ass trip.
It feels so long because we had to literally drive the speed limit the whole way.
So we ended up stopping at some little corner store getting energy drinks and chips and stuff like that. Anyway, and as we were driving here, like I say, the truck was raggedy as hell, so I really had to go past the speed limit. I almost hit somebody in the ass. And I had to hit the brakes so hard, like so hard. Cause again, the truck was raggedy as hell. And as we driving, or anybody know, as you come to Houston, like some of the roads is kind of bumping, you know, kind of tight or whatever. So some of the stuff broke.
It's a stretch of the highway on I-10 that as soon as you cross over into Texas from Louisiana, you know, the road is a bit of a roller coaster, and it's very, very narrow because it's under construction. And there are barricades literally on the end of each lane on both sides. So you literally have to hold your steering wheel so you won't lose control of your car because the road is throwing you in all type of different directions. And so, yeah, I lost my favorite vase to that raggedy road. I really wanted that vase. That vase, I knew in my mind where that vase was going and everything. And I'm upset. So, yeah.
So, finally got here after all them thousands of years. And then, unpacking the truck. Like I say, was sweating down. And for, like I say, everybody who don't know, I end up shaving all my hair off. So I had a bald ass head. Like right now, I have this thing on, but I gotta reshave my head, but that's not a point of the video anyway. So again, sweat was dripping. Oh, let me go back. So once we got the truck here to the new apartment complex,
He hit these people building.
They can't tell those.
He hit these people building.
A little smaller hole.
The nosy neighbor came outside because his blinds was already open. So obviously he saw what happened. he heard and saw what happened. So he came outside looking at the building like he owned it. You just a resident who stayed here. So mind your business. Now he didn't cause any type of damage to the building whatsoever. It was like a little bitty small hole that you literally not gonna, you gotta be really right up on it, close to the wall, for you to see what happened. So yeah, but he came outside, was like throwing his hands up in the air, like, bro, go back inside.
So yeah, now after all that, unpacking and stuff, everybody's sweating, I'm sweating. Again, I had no hair to catch my sweat, so it's all dripping down.
Everybody tired and was tired and ready to go.
End up, had to go get gas for the truck. And when they first gave me the truck, it was like on 3/4 of a tank. And anybody know, if you get a U-Haul or whatever, you have to put the gas back on where they gave it to you as or whatever. Anyway.
Also, it was on 3/4 of a tank.
It's on 3/4 of a tank.
That's 3/4 of a tank?
Oh yeah, it was on.
That's 3/4 of a tank?
It was on 3/4 of a tank.
So it took over $50 to get it like halfway back to where it was.
Let's see.
It took like over $50 to get it halfway back to where it was.
I'm about to send it.
So I'm gonna add a screenshot somewhere of what the gas thing was when we got the truck. I'm gonna add it somewhere up here.
Oh yeah, here it go. Yeah, it was at 3/4 of a tank.
So I'll put this picture on this video.
Yeah, 3/4 of a tank. But I forgot what I put in there the first time. I think maybe $30, and then I went back the second time and put however much amount. But it had just moved to half, and after I said fuck it, because I was tired, ready to go park that bastard back where it needed to be parked at.
Yeah, I just told him to go on, bring it back.
They gonna charge, well, like I said again, if whoever rented a U-Haul, they know what how they do it, how they work. They gonna end up charging you anyway if you don't put the gas back to where it need to be at. But like I said, I was tired as fuck. I didn't care if they charged me or not, because
of the piece of the story that you're about to hear, which God is so good all the time.
Maybe I wasn't gonna tell them that.
God is so good all the time.
But I forgot before I, because I did go there, I forgot a part of the store. When I had went to talk to Kevin after he had told me that he's gonna have the truck rail, and I still went there, so he did say that he's gonna give me a refund.
We're gonna have to hurry up. So Karen about to die.
I forgot to say that. He said he's gonna give me a refund, but yeah, I got that refund. Plus more. But that's not here or there.
God is so good. All the time.
But
God is so good. All the time.
But yeah, like I say, it was some ups and downs when it came to U-Haul because of them messing the time up and pushing everything back and stuff. But again, that refund was all worth it. So yeah.
Yeah. So I guess that was the whole story time about the crazy U-Haul situation. Do we have any more story times of moving? No.
Oh. See, it was hard too when we were taking the stuff off the truck, because the dresser It was like a heavy ass dresser. But god damn, the battery about to die.
Let us know. We'll just do another story time about that. That'll be another part about the whole actually moving. Put some elbow grease in it. That'll be on the next video if we decide to do another mukbang, which that'll be soon. But the camera's about to die. We're about to wrap up this video before the camera shut off. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe again. Turn on post notifications. Hit that bell so you know where we're dropping. My bad, you guys. The camera died right here. I had to prop my phone up on the thing. Again, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Turn the post notifications. Hit that bell so you know where we're dropping episodes. And yeah, that's it. And we'll let you guys know about the next hilarious story time about our movie.